Before acquiring any photo books, my only way of consuming work is through YouTube and Instagram, but more likely Instagram. I did not understand the importance of owning a photo book until I had one. At this point, I only own two photo books, one from Todd Hido and one from Gunnar Stahl. This photo book from Todd is Intimate Distance. This book is a collection of photos he has made from 1968 to 2001. I bought this book primarily because I was on the hunt for his infamous book, House Hunting, which I could no longer find since it was originally released in 2001. But recently there was a re-release of the said book, but I did not bother picking one up because I already have this book. Also, I want to focus on his house hunting photos because those are the images that actually captured my attention, as well as the images that made me appreciate the suburbs. Todd's work in House Hunting encapsulates feelings of eeriness, isolation, and detachment, which are all depicted by foggy, single-lighted window houses taken at night. I feel as though I am looking at these houses in person, as if I am standing next to it and feeling all distant emotions. These photos of his were made in the American suburbs, which gave me great inspiration to adopt where I live and shoot likewise. Now, I find great appreciation and new perspective in the regular things I come across every day, all because of Todd. The second photo book that I have, which I actually acquired a few days ago, is Portraits by Gunnar Stahl. This book is a collection of photos from the most influential and famous hip-hop artists to date. I came across Gunnar from watching a video on YouTube where he was featured and interviewed about his process of shooting and how he became the hip-hop artist's photographer. His philosophy in his work is very simple. Take candid moments of artists doing their own thing.
I like just being just basically like a fly on the wall, just chilling and taking pictures. I don't ever like to ask like, yo, let's go take like this super stage picture with you over here next to this, and I'm gonna be over here. I just, you know, we just chilled, and they just do whatever they do, and I do whatever I do. All of my work is just natural. You can't get any more, what's the word I'm looking for? What's the word besides raw? You can't get more unfiltered than an unstaged film photo. It's impossible.
I find this so simple yet powerful, and it kind of reminds me of the saying, less is more. Also, most of the photos he made in this book are not at all sophisticated and were made using a point and shoot camera with a flash. I think the simplicity in Gunnar's process is what makes his photos stand out and appear naturally appealing. And another reason why I like Gunnar's book is because of my taste in fashion and music, as well as my interest in taking fashion editorial type of photographs. Lastly, I want to feature this mini zine created by my close friends, Kurt and Julia. This zine is a series of photos of trendy streetwear outfits worn by Kurt, and the photos were taken by Julia. The vast majority of these photos were taken on film with a thrifted point-and-shoot camera, which personifies Gunner's philosophy on taking photos. I was very excited to see this print in person because it looks really different from the images that were on Kurt's Instagram. I like how they curated the photos and the order in which they appear. According to Kurt, they made it such that the outfits were on the left and the chosen sneaker to pair the fit is on the right of the page. And personally, I would buy this if this was an actual print for sale. If you guys are actually interested in picking a copy, I would link Kurt and Julia's Instagram down below. Shoot them a DM if you'd like to. There is no better way of consuming an artist's work than having the actual art form in print. There is more to it than just its digital copy. And I think this is a start of a new pursuit for myself: collecting photo books. And that's pretty much it for this video. Thanks for tuning in. And if you like the video, please like the video. And if you're new here, welcome. Consider subscribing for more amazing content in the future. And you can also check out my work at Analogville on Instagram. And also check Kurt and Julia's Instagram for their work as well in the description, like I said. And until next time, peace.